is. John 3 and 7 and John 3 and 16 says you must be born again. And the only reason Jesus said it was because simply if you want to get to heaven, you must be born again.
Reading in the Bible, book of John and chapter 3 is a story of a man who's looking good like you and me, saying, what must I do to be free of my sin? Jesus answered, taking it in as well, you must be born again.
Born again, you must be born again, if you want to be forgiven and be free of your sin. Born again, you must be born again, if you want to get to heaven, then you must be born again.
She starts to worry, tell you not to hurry, cause
You know the way we're going in England. When it comes to the tea, you're getting a dessert first, you know. I talked it to the mirror. This is the one about the mirror.
I took a look in the mirror. I said, my oh my, is that you? I don't recognize those tired old eyes. Whose are those whiskers I see? Why is the sober skin showing right there where the hair used to be? My forehead is wrinkled, all furrowed and wrinkled. Looks like a newly plowed field. But the nearer I get to glory, why the less of this means to me. For I'll have a heavenly body, or a handsome one, just wait and see. My shoelaces give me some bother. I've got a few aches and pains. I can bend low, but the further I go, why it's hard getting back up again. I once was contentious and sporty, but nowadays I'm just content. I can't be bothered with this, that, or the other, for I get up and go. Show no interest in me. But sure, I don't care. I've had my share when I was single and free. Now, God give me Francis to cherish. She says I still look so young. Now, some of you guessed it. She needs her eyes tested. I spoiled her fun.
Place to go to, and I can't wait. That means, doesn't mean to say I'm quite ready to go now, but I just, you know, it's something I somewhere obviously want to go to, and we just want as many people to go there as to, and that's why we need to share Jesus with them. So thank you, gentlemen. We look forward to hearing from you later on. Those of you who have been before, we're going to open up these doors, and we're going to go through the library and through the secret passage and into the main dining room. And if you pick up your supper there, just come back in. There are tables out here. If you want to sit down, please do so. Or you can sit in here as well and eat off your lap. I think there's about 36 places. So half of you will be able to sit down, half of you won't. So no fighting. So that will happen now. So you go out, get your food, bring it back, eat it, and then there's the dessert, which you go out and a cup of tea as well. So just if you know the process, just follow everybody else if you don't know it. And we will resume probably in about 20, 25 minutes, half an hour, depending on how quickly you can. Okay, so perhaps maybe we could bow our heads and give thanks. Let's pray. Our loving Father, thank you for the prospect of heaven. Thank you for what awaits those who love you. Thank you that you have called, chosen, redeemed. Lord, what a privilege to know you as Father. Thank you that one day there will be rejoicing in heaven when we enter. Thank you, Lord, for those that we will see that have gone before. Thank you for all that there will be in store for us. Thank you for Jesus who makes this possible. We just trust in him, we believe in him, our sins are forgiven, we are born again, we are given by your Spirit a new way of life to live as chosen people, adopted into the family of God. Lord, we thank you for your goodness. We thank you for this evening, we thank you for worship, we thank you for the gentlemen singing. And Lord, we thank you now for an opportunity to have something to eat, and we pray you bless the food to our bodies. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen.
Singing, these mics have quite a long lead. That's not a threat, that's a promise. So there we are.